Hey guys, thanks for joining me again today. A couple of weeks ago I posted a video about the Meris Mercury X and how it can be used as a piece of outboard hardware in Pro Tools or any other door. And in the comments section someone asked about the Strymon Nightsky because they were considering buying one or the other. So today we're going to be taking a look at the Strymon Nightsky and what this can do for you in your mix. So let's jump in. So here is the Strymon Nightsky. Now, basically the Nightsky is a reverberant synthesis workstation, according to Strymon, and a powerful hands-on experimental sound design platform. So what this gives you is a real-time continuous control of reverb pitch, processing rate, core size, harmonics, and even a synth-like resonant filter with multiple modulation wave shapes, plus a step sequencer with variable guide. You haven't heard a pedal like this before. Now that's just me reading off Strymon's website. However, in practice, I've used this for some time now. Now, there are some great videos on YouTube going into absolutely huge detail about exactly what this pedal does and how it works. Let me give you a very brief overview. Alright, first things first, let's try on some vocals.
Eddie. You're heavy in my heart. In my head. Heavy care. That loneliness that takes you apart. Puts you to bed.
So there are a few things that are different about this pedal than a standard other reverb pedal, I guess. Now, on the front panel, you've got some familiar controls, I guess, that you would see on any other sort of reverb pedal. However, if you look a little closely and a little bit under the hood, there's a few things on here that you're probably not used to seeing. The first one being this modulation section. Now, this has a bunch of different, what are essentially LFO filters, and you can go from random, envelope, and different wave patterns. Now, the target for this can either be the reverb, the pitch, or a filter. So you can use the shape and the target to target other areas of the reverb, which is kind of really, really cool. So over here, you have a quantized control button. Now this allows you to change the size and pitch of the reverb between a scale, smooth, or sequential or half step. This can be controlled gradually via the potentiometer. So you can, let's say you're mixing down a track, you can actually perform with this as well. You've also then got different types of decay, whether it be sparse, dense, diffuse, and you can change the length here with this potentiometer as well. So that controls your kind of basic reverb settings. You've also got shimmer, drive, glimmer, all those kind of things. This bank here of buttons represent presets. However, when you're in scale mode, you can also pick the scale as well, and that is how that is controlled. So, the Strymon Nightsky, would I recommend it over the Meris Mercury X? Well, that depends. If you're looking for a reverb that is a character pedal or something that you use once in a while for a specific sound, I think the Nightsky is really good for that. Yes, it can do regular sounding reverbs and they are really, really nice, but for me, in that regard, the Meris beats it. I've found that right off the bat, the Meris had some reverbs in it that were just absolutely gorgeous and you could just use them as stock reverbs. I find with the Strymon and the way the interface is laid out on the front, it's a little bit more difficult to achieve that because this is a product that's designed to be warped and messed with and, you know, it's designed to be a creative force. Now, if that's what you're looking for, then the Strymon is a great shout. It will give you all types of weird and wonderful ethereal noises, reverbs, you know, modular synth noises, all that kind of thing. If you're one of these people that likes to tinker around with pedals, this is the pedal for you. That being said, the Meris is also completely and utterly user customizable, but I have read online that other people have found the Meris to be a little bit confusing at times, and in that regard, the Strymon is laid out a lot easier. It's just buttons. You turn it, you push knobs, you make sounds. With the Meris having that digital interface, it can be a little bit lost in the menus sometimes. Like the Meris, the Nightsky, as well as Strymon's other pedals, do offer stereo in and out, as well as a difference between mic or line level. So you can run a guitar straight into this, or you can switch it to line and run it out of your door, which is what I'm doing today. It's also MIDI controllable, and that is, I believe, over USB as well. So if you've got 15-pin MIDI or you've got USB, you should be good to go on either of those fronts. In terms of the price, they actually come up pretty regularly on the second-hand market these days. If you're going to go out and buy one new, you'd be looking at around about the £399 mark in the UK and about $429 in the US. So it is a little cheaper than the Meris. Thanks a lot for watching today's video, and I do hope that you're getting some value from the content and you are enjoying it. If that is the case, please consider subscribing and I would very much appreciate it. Until I see you again, take care and be well.